So this weekend, I took some time to better organize parts of my collection. And I am not talking about the immediate collection that is in this room with me right now versus the extended collection that is in the garage right below me. I spent several hours this weekend trying to get things a little better organized. And while I was in the garage, I had several epiphanies and thoughts that I wanted to share with you as to why having a better organized collection might actually be advantageous. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 practical tips for why it makes sense to get a little better organized. And my overall goal here at the channel was to help you to make sense of comic book collecting. And part of that is very practical tips that I hope to share with you in videos like this. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, I definitely want to encourage you to do so. That way you don't miss out on any of the content that comes out from the channel. Before I get to those 5 tips, I want to take a moment to acknowledge the sponsor of this video, Shortboxed. This app is the easiest and safest way to buy and sell graded comics. There is a link down in the description of this video. Click it, head over, and check out the amazing collection that you are going to find there. I've been using this app consistently for a couple of years now, and it does not disappoint. With that said, let's go ahead and get to the 5 tips. Tip number 1 is that by having a better organized collection, it is easy to locate books when it's time to sell. Trust me when I tell you, there is nothing worse than thinking that you have a book in your collection and not being able to find that book. That will drive you crazy. Trust me on this one, I know from experience. And honestly, the 100K collection is not as disorganized as it might seem. I do, by and large, know what is in many of the bins as I've gone through them, and I've listed on the front of the bin the types of titles that are contained within that bin, but I don't necessarily know every single book. So while it's sort of organized, it can always be improved. And for example, this weekend I spent time grouping Batman-related books together, Superman-related books together, mutant-related books, and so on and so forth to make it a little bit easier for me to locate a bin and then a book within that bin. So taking some steps to get things better organized. But again, the big thing here is by doing some organization, by potentially inventorying your collection, you know what's in there. And if you know what's in there, if something gets hot or if you have a desire to sell something, it is relatively easy to find that book so that you can move it out to someone that might want it and, you know, get some cash in so you can do some other things with it. Tip number 2 is that by being better organized, it prevents you from going crazy. And again, I alluded to this a second ago. There is nothing worse than thinking that you have a book in your collection and not being able to find that book for some reason or another. And I will tell you that there are some folks out there that are much more organized than I. They have full inventories of their collections, either in something like CLZ or in a spreadsheet or some other type of database. And I honestly applaud people for that level of organization. With the size of my collection, that is a little bit of a daunting task, but I am constantly making some improvements and some strides. When it comes to my slab books, I think I have a much better hold of those books, as many of them have actually been inserted into the Go Collect database. Go Collect has this wonderful report, it's a value report that allows you not only to track the books that you have slabs, but to see how much you pay for those books, as well as to report out the value of those slab books that you've actually put into the system. It's actually a pretty awesome report that I use for insurance purposes and just to make sure I know what's in my slabs. The raw books is a little bit more of a challenge, but again, we are taking steps. And again, I'm making this video as much for myself as I'm making it for you all as well. Tip number 3 is that by being better organized, you might actually prevent waste. And the waste that I'm talking about is buying the same books repeatedly by accident. By having a catalog of the books that are in your collection, and by being able to quickly reference what is in your collection, you are less likely to accidentally buy the same book over and over. And I know that there are people out there that have done that, that have accidentally purchased the same book multiple times because they cannot remember exactly what is in their collection. And I too am guilty of this, so I cannot point fingers without pointing a few at myself. And so this is, by being better organized, one of those easy ways to make sure that when you're spending money wisely. So get organized, do an inventory, make sure you know what's in your collection so as to prevent you from spending money unnecessarily. Tip number four is that by being better organized, there is a sense of serenity that comes along with that. By having everything be in its place and you knowing what's there, there is a feeling of satisfaction that more than likely will wash over you. I can tell you from experience that there is something to be said for having a clean comic book room where every comic is put in its proper place and they aren't stacked in corners or stacked together. The books that you've recently purchased are all in their bins, and you look at a bin of comics and you realize that all of the bins are in new bags and boards and they're all the same size. There is a certain amount of satisfaction that comes from those things, that comes from being organized. And so sometimes, again, spending a little time controlling the chaos will give you a wonderful feeling of satisfaction, and that cannot be overlooked. Tip number five is that by being better organized, you potentially are better protecting and preserving your comics. Take the time to bag and board your books and to put them in bins where they are actually protected from the elements. They are protected from UV light. They are protected from children and from pets if you have those. They're also protected from the accident-prone collector. And I can tell you again from experience that I've had stacks of comics here in the room that I've accidentally knocked over as I've tried to make my way from one side of the room to another. So by being more careful, by keeping books where they are supposed to be, you are protecting and preserving those comics for the long term. And you're protecting not only your value that might come from those comics, but you're also protecting the money that you've spent. Again, there's nothing worse than spending some money on something that gets damaged simply from being careless. So take the time to bag and board your comics, put them in a bin, and make sure that they are safe. With that said, I'm going to wrap this video up. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And again, I want to give a huge shout out to the sponsor of this video, Shortbox. I encourage you to click on the link in the description of this video. Check them out. I think that you're going to be pleasantly surprised. If you need to reach out to me, feel free to do so on Instagram at Regie Collects. And if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, I want to encourage you to go ahead and hit that button, turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on any of the content that comes out from the channel. Take care. Be sure to leave a substantive comment behind on this video for a chance to win a $100 credit from my friends at Shortboxed. The credit can be used towards the purchase of anything that you find on the app, which is available in the US. And stay tuned for an upcoming live stream, specifically Comics Today, to find out who the random winner will be.